Julian Assange. Now, in its report, the newspaper says it has an email dated August 4th, 2016, in which Stone wrote he'd had dinner with Assange, then is now pretty much confined to the Ecuadorian embassy in London. An email Stone tells the paper was a joke. I'm joined now by one of the reporters who wrote the story, Shelby Holliday. So, Shelby, Roger Stone says this isn't true, that he never dined with Assange, and that, quote, it's not what you say, it's what you do. This was said in jest. That's not dissuaded Mueller's team, it seems, based on your reporting, from actually looking into it. Is that correct?
Right. So there's an email, and it says he dined with Julian Assange. As you said, he tells us it's a joke. He did not deny that he actually wrote this email. He simply said it was all just a big joke, claiming that he had been in touch with Julian Assange. We do know that after he wrote this email, he went on to tell a crowd in Florida he had been in contact with Julian Assange. And his statements have shifted over the past year. He told the House Intelligence Committee, according to reports, that he spoke to Assange through an intermediary, that when we approached him about this story, he said he never talked to Assange in 2016, especially on that day on August 3rd, 2016. If you pull back and look at the timeline here, this comes a few days, his email comes a few days after President Trump called on Russia to find Hillary Clinton's missing emails. And it also comes after reported contacts between Paul Manafort, who's facing a number of charges, and a man that the special counsel's office said hinted at is linked to Russian intelligence, Konstantin Kalimnik. So that timeline leading up to this email is very curious. And then following the email, Roger Stone went on Twitter and praised Julian Assange. He predicted that it would be the Podesta's time in the barrel. He went on to say liberals want WikiLeaks to stand down, but he won't. They won't. The payload is coming. So he predicted this email release for months after the email that said he dined with Julian Assange.
Do you know whether Ecuadorian officials in London have been cooperating with Mueller's team? I mean, obviously, Assange is holed up at the embassy there for years. If there actually was a dinner with Roger Stone,
right?
I mean, it would have to have been at the embassy.
Well, that's right. That's unclear. And also, Julian Assange was not available to respond to comment. He has not had internet access off and on recently, so it's hard to know. Roger Stone actually sent us a screen grab. We gave him multiple days to prove to us that he was not in London, because that's where he'd have to be. All he sent us was a screen grab of what appeared to be a flight booking with the name Roger. He said he was flying from Los Angeles to Miami on that night and couldn't possibly have been in London. But I've talked to different prosecutors, and some say dining doesn't necessarily have to mean that he was there in person. He could have called him on the phone and caught him during dinner, or maybe they had FaceTimed. Other prosecutors say that's pretty concrete language, and dining would mean dining. But at this point, there's no, beyond the email, beyond the screenshot booking, we don't have any proof that Roger Stone was or was not in London, and he didn't provide any other evidence. He scoffed at me when I asked if he could put me in touch with people he had been with on that day, and he sort of just laughed the whole thing off. And even when I asked, is there a 2016 on the screenshot, he said, are you kidding me? So it's hard to know. It's hard to know. And even people close to Roger Stone say they aren't exactly sure when to believe him and when he's telling the truth or when he's not.
Yeah, I mean, there is sort of a performance art at times to some of his statements in the past.
Right. He calls himself a political trickster. And if you watch the documentary Get Me Roger Stone, he actually really loves this reputation that he pulls off political tricks, and sometimes he does things. He says he's never broken the law, but that he does things that sort of raise eyebrows and stir the pot, I guess you could say. What's unclear is if he was communicating with WikiLeaks and also Guccifer, some people call him Guccifer, if he's talking to these two groups that spread hacked emails, Hillary Clinton's emails before the election, did he know that they were working in tandem with Russia, as U.S. intelligence agencies have said? And did he have knowledge of a hack and still encourage the release of these emails? That would be a crime under the federal the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. Because even if you know of the crime, you didn't commit the crime, but you helped spread it or you helped disseminate the emails, you could be in trouble.
Yeah. Shelby Holliday, appreciate the reporting. Thanks very much.
Just
ahead, President Trump goes on a weekend tweet storm and declares DACA dead. He's also on the attack once again against the mainstream media. No surprise there. The latest on all of that ahead.